Well, hello, everyone, and welcome to Play by Play. It's the Jamie Yarrow podcast. It's the podcast that you rely on for your daily dose of everything from business to wellness to parenting to sports. You get it all here. And we don't just talk about it. We give you the play by play. We give you the nuggets. We give you all the nitty gritty. We give you the playbook, if you will. Today, we're going to be finishing up our four-part series discussing the keys to job security. And today's episode is all about connecting with people. Now be sure you check out all of our other full episodes and our two-minute drills. And if you love what you hear, there's nothing more that we would like than if you subscribed and shared our podcast. Now, let's get ready for today's play-by-play. I'm your host, Jamie Yarrow, and kickoff is counting down. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you may be listening. We are live from the Clawfice, that is the Closet Office, aka the Play-by-Play Studio. This is a full episode. It's number 57. Now, before we get started today, I want to ask you to pray for a dear friend of ours, of our families. His name is Brent, and he was involved in a Wave Runner accident with his daughter on Friday. His daughter's okay, but Brent is in critical condition. He had to be life-flighted to the hospital, and he's got a long road ahead of him. And so I just ask you to be in prayer for him and his family. His wife's name is Sandy, and his daughter's name is Kennedy. If you would add them to your prayer list, I would be grateful, and I know that they would be. And I would thank you from the bottom of my heart for praying for them. Dear friends of ours, and we just really wish them the best. Amazing people. Today's episode is the final episode in a four-part series dealing with job security in uncertain times. Now, for these four episodes, we've been covering a number of topics, and those topics are designed to keep you in your current role, or if that's not in the cards, to help you prepare for whatever that next role is in your life. Now, the series was inspired by an article that was written by Mary Curl. It was published in the Muse. We've taken that article and we've expanded on it to create this series of episodes. Now, a link to that article is in the show notes if you want to read it firsthand. Now, each of these episodes, they can be listened to independently. So go back and check out the first three if you didn't get a chance to listen to them. They're about 20 minutes long a piece. Now, today it's all about connecting with people. One thing that I've found to be true during this crazy COVID time that we're going through is it is possible to stay as connected or as disconnected as you want. At the time of this recording, most states in the U.S. are starting to lift some of their restrictions and allowing people to, you know, go and do their thing. And so, yeah, you can probably get out and you can start seeing people face to face again, but there's still a tremendous ability to connect virtually. Now, how many of you, like me, have become seriously proficient with Zoom over the past 8 weeks or so? I was using Zoom prior to all of this, but I can definitely tell you I have become quite the Zoom master over the last, you know, couple months. I read an article about the number of Zoom users, and it said in January they had about 10 million users, and then in April they were up to 200 million users. So for a while, you know, they had the corner on the market. But did you see now that Facebook just released Facebook Rooms? It's a new feature that allows kind of a Zoom-like meeting. It's a, you know, video conference meeting type room. It doesn't have all the advanced features of Zoom, but it's very streamlined. It's super easy to use. I mean, virtually no learning curve. I used it yesterday for the first time, and surprisingly, it was really quite effective for the meeting. I was expecting some bugs and glitches and that kind of stuff, but it really went quite well. It's very basic, so it's super easy to use. And, you know, it looks like they focused on, when they were developing it, they focused on it being streamlined and, efficient without a lot of frills. So you may want to try it out. Aside from those apps, you know, you still have Google Hangouts and FaceTime and Skype. I don't know if anybody still uses Skype or not, but they all allow you to connect to virtually anyone, anywhere in the world. And so I would ask you, are you using these types of things to keep current with the people that are in your circle, or are using them to add to your circle? We're talking all about job security in these episodes, and one of the ways to help ensure that you can weather this storm is to stay visible, right? I've talked a lot about staying engaged in your company and bringing value. So what kind of value can you bring through being able to continually network, to be able to network virtually to people across the country or even in your own town that you can't see face to face? I mean, think about it. In your application, so just apply it to your application. I mean, maybe you can bring in new clients. Maybe you can close deals with existing clients. Maybe there are people in your industry who aren't willing to do things like video conference or, you know, utilize the technology that's available to connect. And so if your client needs service and you're willing to go the extra mile to be able to communicate with them, maybe you get the deal. Maybe you can strengthen your relationship with others, you know, colleagues or other clients, or maybe you can negotiate with suppliers or vendors, or you can facilitate meetings between remote offices. I mean, you get the point. What are ways that you can do, that you can use this remote communication to help bring value and stay engaged and stay visible in your company when others in your organization are struggling to learn all these technologies to stay connected? How about you become the expert? I mean, how about this? When business gets back to some sense of normalcy, can you show your company how they can save money by connecting remotely versus some of the on-site travel? Maybe you can cut down on some of that travel budget. Maybe you can find ways to, you know, be more efficient and reduce costs by using some of these technologies. I think one of the huge benefits of COVID is going to be this new awareness of the effectiveness of remote communication tools. I mean, who will be the one that leads that charge in your organization? If that's you, then that's a huge feather in your cap, right? And you might say, well, I don't even know how to learn this stuff. I mean, how can I learn this? And I would tell you that that's the easy part. I mean, you can ask a friend to connect with you outside of work hours. You can practice using these tools in the evening. You can practice on the weekends. You can get schooled up or get, you know, up to speed on these tools pretty easily. I mean, you can become proficient on your own time and then make suggestions in your organization about how it would be best utilized. I mean, you know the processes and you know how your organization works. So when you become proficient with these tools, then you're in a better position to be able to make suggestions. I mean, you'll be informed. You're going to stay engaged in a different way in your company, and you're going to be the expert resource that they turn to. And the last thing that we'll touch on, and this is actually going to finish up our episode and our four-part series, is the idea of being empathetic. Now, empathy differs from sympathy in that with empathy, you have, or you have in the past at least, you've experienced the same things that the other person is going through. For instance, maybe you've lost a parent and you can feel empathy for someone else that has, right? If you've never walked in those shoes, then you can have sympathy for someone, meaning that you feel sorry for them or you have sorrow for them, but you really can't know how they feel, right? Curl writes in this article that those who show empathy will make the people they work with feel good, and then they're more likely to keep their jobs. Well, I would take that a step further and say, and as unpopular as this may sound, it's harder to get rid of somebody that's liked. I mean, I've seen it over and over and over in my career. Somebody who is liked in the organization is less likely to find themselves without a job than somebody who's not so liked. And I think that this is especially true in small and mid-sized businesses. I mean, the fact of the matter is, the more that the boss likes you, the more secure your job is. Of course, that doesn't always translate to security, but I mean, at the very least, it sure can't hurt, right? But the more important thing about being empathetic is it's just a good thing to do. It's the right thing to do. When you help someone, you feel better, even if that help is just a listening ear. When you feel better, your mood and your outlook is better. When your mood and your outlook is better, you perform better. You're more enjoyable to be around. You're better able to handle change, right? Helping others, even if it's just being a good listener, gives you a sense of joy. Remember the golden rule? Do unto others as you would have done unto you. Treat others like you want to be treated. Be empathetic. Be sympathetic if necessary. Be a good listener. Be a friend. And all that is going to help you to be the best version of yourself. Well, that's all the time we got, and that is going to finish out all of this series of episodes. As a reminder, this is just the final episode in the series, so I encourage you to go back and listen to the first three episodes. They all have some nuggets that are going to help you as you journey through this COVID crisis. The best way to make sure that you don't miss any future episodes is to subscribe. So go ahead while you're listening, open that app, and go ahead and hit the subscribe button on your app. Go ahead and do it. Reach up there, hit the subscribe button. There you go. Now, every time we release a new episode, you'll get notified. It'll be in your playlist so you can listen to it whenever you have time. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Play by Play. Be sure to check out all of our other episodes, our past episodes, and our two-minute drills. Those are just short little snippets. You can find all those on your favorite podcast player. All you have to do is search for the letters PXP and then click on Play by Play with Jamie Yarrow. Thanks for listening, and most of all, I hope that something we said today helps you to become a better version of yourself. Again, I am Jamie Yarrow, and I hope you have an amazing day.